Having been at the forefront of the local cannabis movement, someone from the Rastafarian community should have been included in the St. Lucia delegation, which recently visited St. Vincent and the Grenadines on a technical mission to learn more of that island's cannabis industry. That's the opinion of Aaron Alexander, the former president of the Iyanola Council for the Advancement of Rastafari. He is deeply upset that neither of the two Rastafarians who sit on the Cannabis Task Force was invited. Commerce Minister and Cannabis Task Force Chair Emma Hippolyte, who led the delegation, was accompanied by the deputy chair and the PRO of the task force. The leader of the National Green Party, Andrew Dicaris, was also invited on the mission, however, was unable to make the trip.
This is most certainly an unacceptable turn of events. The current president of ICAR, Sister Danny James, and another Rastafari representative are both part of the task force. And at least it would have been in good faith and in good taste to have one of them on the delegation to St. Vincent. The optics, therefore, was terrible for the minister, Emma Hippolyte, on this mission. Let me remind this government that when they were in opposition, they promised to have Rastafari reps involved with the cannabis legalization process every step of the way. And the government, in recent times, the past government under the Honorable Alan Chastney also promised the same. So we therefore ask the obvious question: why was the Rastafari community reps excluded or left out of this delegation?
Current ICAR president, Empress Danny James, in responding to her predecessor's comment, says that Alexander does not speak for the organization and that she has no issue with not being included in the delegation.
That is his opinion on what should have happened, but I do not want the Rastafari people to think that the cannabis legalization is a Rastafari thing. It is for the benefit of the whole country. We, the Rastafari people, have been at or been on the task force because government recognized our contributions, and we were the ones always at the forefront of the ones being victimized and arrested for cannabis. So they have awarded us a place, a position, a seat where we now could be part of the discussion. Going down to St. Vincent, I do not have any problem with I not being a delegate going down to St. Vincent, because I do not think the whole task force can go or have to go to St. Vincent. It's a fact-finding mission, and whatever information coming from St. Vincent, I'm sure when the task force meets the Prime Minister, the Minister responsible, Honorable Minister Emma Hippolyte, will brief us, will give the information, will share the information among the task force members.
Alexander's comments were just unfortunate, says the PRO of the Cannabis Task Force, Vern Emmanuel.
The Rastafarian community has been involved in the work of the task force. They participate in all the task force meetings and their subcommittees. We have actively engaged the Rastafarian community in the work as we seek to develop the regulatory framework for cannabis. I think it is not constructive at this time for us to engage in deleterious political diatribe. We have serious work that the task force is undertaking, and we have engaged in a consultative process with the entire society.
A report of the technical mission will be presented, says Emmanuel, at the next Cannabis Task Force meeting scheduled for Wednesday, June 15th, 2022. For the DBS News World, I am Zine Romulus.